My brothers in Islam, today is the first day of Rajab. Today is the first of Rajab. 1,440 years after the Hijrah and migration of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the month of Rajab is one of the sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention in the Holy Quran. Inna iddat ash-shuhur inda Allah 12 shahr. Yawma khalaqa Allah as-samawati wal ard. Minha arba'atun hurum. So the number of months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed and ordained, 12 months. Yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal ard, from the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created the heavens and the earth. Minha arba'atun hurum. 4 months out of the 12 months are sacred months. We call them Ashur al-Hurum. Ashur al-Hurum. So there are 12 months throughout the year. And we're talking about the lunar year, not the solar year, not the Gregorian year and calendar. We're talking about the Islamic calendar, which is part of my Islamic identity and your Islamic identity. And this is the beauty of the Islamic identity. We have our independence. Our slavery is only to Allah and to Islam. Minha arba'atun hurum. From amongst the 12 months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordained, there are 4 sacred months. They are Rajab, the month that we started today. Dhul-Qa'dah, the 11th month. Dhul-Hijjah, the month of Hajj, the 12th month. And the month of Allah, Muharram, the first month in the Islamic calendar. So today is the first of Rajab. And the month of Rajab is the only month that's on its own, not connected to the rest of the 3 other sacred months. Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah and Muharram, 11th, 12th and the 1st are all connected to one another. Rajab is by itself. And what does that mean? Ashurullah al-Hurum, these are sacred months. Before Islam, the Arabs used to sanctify these months. And there are matters that they never used to do in these months. From amongst those matters, they never ever wage war against anyone in the months of Ashur al-Hurum, in the sacred months. And from the other things, they will abstain away from evil deeds, even though they should be abstain away from evil deeds, regardless of the sacred months or not. And that's why Islam came and confirmed and approved some of those actions. And that's why Islam considers those 4 months as sacred months, in which you need to be more vigilant. You should always be vigilant, but this time you need to be more vigilant in doing anything wrong in these months. It doesn't give them any significance. So Rajab, there's no significance about the month of Rajab, as if you're going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Rajab, you're going to get more rewards. Or if you're going to worship Allah azza wa jalla in the month of Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah or Muharram, you're going to get any more rewards. No. But it's just a program, a system for you to keep in mind to continue remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without a doubt, and that's the primary topic of today's khutbah, the most important month out of all the months throughout the year is the month that's around the corner. Can you believe it? That month around the corner. Which month am I alluding to? It is the month of Ramadan. 2 months exactly from now. 2 months exactly from now. We will commence the month of Ramadan. And the month of Ramadan, without a doubt, is the greatest month to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the entire year. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you in the month of Ramadan, He doesn't give you in any other month. And the month of Ramadan just around the corner. Less than 60 days to go for the month of Ramadan. The month of Rahmah, the month of forgiveness, the month of salvation from the hellfire. The month of Ramadan is just around the corner. And I know we as Muslims, we prepare for the month of Ramadan from the very moment that the month of Ramadan has been announced. And that's where we get it wrong. That's where we get it wrong. Yes, we get it wrong. And that's why, my brother in Islam, At the end of the month of Ramadan or after the month of Ramadan, when you evaluate yourself or you assess yourself after the month of Ramadan, you realize you didn't really gain much out of the month of Ramadan. You know why? Because you didn't start properly from the very beginning. You waited for the month of Ramadan to be announced. And then when the Australian National Imams Council announced the beginning of the month of Ramadan, or the moon was sighted at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, everyone now starts to pull their sleeves up and alhamdulillah, now I want to prepare myself. You are wrong, my brother in Islam. You want to prepare for the month of Ramadan. I'm telling you right now, with 60 days to get to the month of Ramadan, less than 2 months to get to the month of Ramadan, you need to prepare now, and now is even late. And later is even worse. 2 months. 2 months to go for the blessed month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan, that the one the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes mention, and he says, the moment the month of Ramadan starts and commences, the gates of the paradise will open and the gates of the hellfire will shut. And I call and will call and say, Ya baghi al-khayri aqbal wa ya baghi al-sharri adbir. All the one that's seeking goodness, come forward. This is your time. This is your moment. This is your month. All the one that's seeking evilness, turn back. This time and every other time is not your time. So when is the month of Ramadan, my brother in Islam? Today, we started the month of Rajab. Today is the first of Rajab. After Rajab, there's the month of Sha'ban. And after Sha'ban, what comes? Ramadan. Subhanallah, so close. They don't realize it's that close. So my question to you, my brother in Islam, are you ready for the month of Ramadan? Are you ready for the month of Ramadan? Have you prepared yourself for the month of Ramadan? Or are you going to wait for the month of Ramadan to commence for you to start preparing yourself for the month of Ramadan? Well, you're wrong. That's why you're not going to gain much out of the month of Ramadan. We are so ambitious in the month of Ramadan. I want to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to achieve 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to do this in the month of Ramadan. I want to do that in the month of Ramadan. Inshallah, after the month of Ramadan, I want to be at that level. I want to make sure that I've achieved this, that, this. But then after the month of Ramadan, nothing is there. Why? Because you didn't prepare for it. You want to come to the exams and you want to get 100 out of 100 in the exam when you haven't even studied. You enter the exam room or the exam hall and you haven't even studied and you expect to get 100 out of 100. When are you going to prepare? I'll prepare when the exam starts. What do you mean you're going to prepare when the exam starts? How are you going to prepare when the exam starts? You should be prepared prior to the exam. You should study. You should have studied before the exam. You should have been well prepared before you even entered the exam room or the exams. That's what we do when it comes to the month of Ramadan. We want to prepare when the month of Ramadan starts. So the month of Ramadan starts, now I start warming up. Now I prepare myself. That's why you get nothing out of the month of Ramadan. Or you know what? I'll take the word nothing. That's why you get very minimal out of the month of Ramadan. Instead of you getting 100, you get 10 out of the month of Ramadan. If not 5. When you aim for 100 and even more, but you only get 5 and 10. Because you haven't prepared yourself. Our predecessors, my brothers in Islam, used to prepare for the month of Ramadan 6 months. Not 2 months. 6 months before the month of Ramadan. This speech that I'm giving you right now, 2 months before the month of Ramadan, the Sahaba and our predecessors, they'll be talking about the month of Ramadan and preparations for the month of Ramadan 6 months before the month of Ramadan, not 2 months. If I had spoken about the month of Ramadan 4 months ago, people would have looked at me and said, Sheikh, isn't it a bit too early? We just came out of the month of Ramadan. Why are you talking about the month of Ramadan? There's still 6 months to go for the month of Ramadan. Maybe even some of you are even thinking, why is the Sheikh even talking about the month of Ramadan when there's 2 months to go for the month of Ramadan? Well, my brother in Islam, you should have been prepared 2 months or even 4 months ago for the month of Ramadan, when the month of Ramadan is only 2 months away from now. So are you ready or not? Start preparing yourself for the month of Ramadan from now. From now. Don't wait for the announcement of the commencement of the month of Ramadan to come out and say the month of Ramadan is tomorrow. We become very proactive. More proactive on the announcement of the commencement of the month of Ramadan and the end of the month of Ramadan than what we need to do in the month of Ramadan. The debate start. Okay, you're going to go with moonsighting, you're going to go with calculation, you're going to go with this organization, you're going to go with that organization, you're going to go with this sheikh, or you're going to go with that sheikh, you're going to go with this country, or you're going to go with that country, you're going to go with global sighting, or you're going to go with local sighting. We get caught up with that, and we forget the core issue. What's the core issue? Preparing yourself for the month of Ramadan, not preparing yourself for the debate of the month of Ramadan. Now people prepare themselves for the debates. We prepare ourselves. SubhanAllah, look what we get ourselves caught up in. I'm not undermining the importance of the fiqh of this matter. This is a different topic here. But this is a lot more important than the debate. There's something called connecting myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's given me this opportunity once a year. Once a year for me to reconnect myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's given me this opportunity once a year for me to sit with myself and start reconnecting myself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's given me this opportunity once a year for me to make up for my mistakes, for my shortcomings, for my downfalls in the last 11 months. Allah's given me this opportunity for me to make it up. So I'm going to get caught up with other things. The month of Ramadan, Allahu Akbar. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to describe the month of Ramadan as the gift of Allah. Gift, mercy, grace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you treat the month of Ramadan as a gift? Do you treat the month of Ramadan as a grace from Allah? Do you treat the month of Ramadan as a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My brother in Islam, the month of Ramadan is less than 60 days to go. So prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan. So what do I need to do to prepare myself for the month of Ramadan? Number one, set your heart straight. Set your heart straight. What do I mean by that? Be sincere about the month of Ramadan and about your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan and about what you want to achieve in the month of Ramadan for the sake of Allah. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. What you intend for is what Allah gives you. What's your intention? What do you want to gain out of the month of Ramadan? Do you want to gain out of the month of Ramadan the pleasure of Allah, reconnecting yourself to Allah, becoming closer to Allah, being forgiven by Allah, and Allah accepting your repentance in the month of Ramadan? Or is the month of Ramadan about you staying awake all night and hanging out with your mates and eating and drinking? Alhamdulillah, we eat a lot more in the month of Ramadan. Forget about diet. That's not going to happen. Go and speak to the restaurants. Speak to the shopkeepers. The toy. Alhamdulillah, what they do in the month of Ramadan more than what they do in 11 months. People are supposed to be fasting. Yes, they fast for 12 hours, but they eat for 12 hours too. And I'm not saying that's bad. Don't get me wrong, but some people, the month of Ramadan is the month of food, the month of sweets. You know what? No issues with that. Sahtain. I'm happy for you. And I'm sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not displeased from you. But that's not the primary focus here. That's not what I want to achieve out of the month of Ramadan. What I want to achieve out of the month of Ramadan is to be forgiven by Allah, the Lord of Ramadan. I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy to shower me. I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remember me. I want to be from amongst those that's been recorded by Allah azza wa jal in the sacred and holy records of Allah that you are forgiven. You are forgiven. That's what I want to get out of the month of Ramadan. I want to feel at the end of the month of Ramadan or after the month of Ramadan, I want to feel that a lot more closer to Allah. I feel that I'm close to Allah. I have that sense of feeling of that connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I feel connected to Allah. That's what I want to feel after the month of Ramadan. Do you feel that? Did you feel that last year? Did you feel that in last Ramadan? Or the Ramadan before that? Or the Ramadan before that Ramadan? Subhanallah, what happens to us? What happens? So set your heart straight. Whatever you intend for is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you in return. Secondly, my brother in Islam, set your mind straight. After you set your heart straight, Align your mind with it. Set your mind straight. What do I mean by that? Make sure that you have the right mindset. What's in your mind? What's your goal? What's your target? Put a goal for yourself. You work every single day because you have a goal. You want to finish this job and you want to get paid. That's your goal. No one goes to work because they want to go and work. You have a goal for yourself. You set yourself a goal. So you've set your mind straight. This is what I want to achieve out of my work, out of my studies, out of my tasks. Set your mind straight in the month of Ramadan. That's something that you need to work on before the month of Ramadan. Not in the month of Ramadan. Not at the beginning of the month of Ramadan. Not the end of the month of Ramadan. This is something you start working on now. Set your mind straight. What do you want to achieve out of the month of Ramadan? What are your goals? What do you want to gain out of the month of Ramadan? I can give you some tips, but it goes back to you. Everyone knows themselves. I want to be forgiven by Allah. I want to be accepted by Allah. I want to be safe from the hellfire of Allah. I want to feel closer to Allah. I want to connect myself to the book of Allah. Set yourself some goals in the month of Ramadan. Set it from now. Start working on it from now. Put your list. Don't come to the job interview and then the interviewer, the boss or the manager asks you questions and like, I need to think about it. Well, you know what? You're not going to get that job. I guarantee you're not going to get that job. Imagine you apply for a job and you've got the interviewer that's interviewing you and he asks you, okay, what's your objective of this? Let me think about it. What do you want to gain out of this job? Let me think about it. What's your ambition out of this job? Let me think about it. What's going to happen? You know what? We're not even going to think about you being hired or not. Just get out of here. You're waiting for the month of Ramadan for you to set your mind straight? Set it now. Now is the time that you start setting your mind straight. Set your mind straight. Set your heart straight. Set your mind straight. And thirdly, my brothers in Islam, set your actions straight. Set your actions straight. You don't want to enter the month of Ramadan and you are still indulging in the haram, still perpetrating the haram, still committing the haram. You want to enter the month of Ramadan, you've already set your actions straight. You've already repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not waiting for the month of Ramadan to start for you to repent to Allah. You've already repented to Allah azza wa jalla. That's something that you need to work on now. Set your actions straight. Set your actions straight. Repent to Allah from now. 99.9% of the Muslims, they think about, inshallah, when the month of Ramadan comes, I'm going to stop this, and I'm going to stop that, and I'm going to stop the haram, I'm going to stop the sins. Why? Stop it from now. The Lord of Ramadan, Allah, exists in Ramadan, before the month of Ramadan, after the month of Ramadan. Set your actions straight from now. Stop the haram from now. Stop the sins from now. Stop displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from now. Start working on it. Prep yourself. Prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan. You've got 60 days to go. So set your heart straight. Set your mind straight. Set your actions straight. So you could get the most out of the month of Ramadan. My brothers in Islam, once again, prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is around the corner. Literally, yes, around the corner. Subhanallah, as if yesterday we're talking about the end of the month of Ramadan. As if before yesterday we spoke about the beginning of the month of Ramadan. As if yesterday we're talking about this last year. But subhanallah, already started a new month. And then another month. And then it's going to be the month of Ramadan. So prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan. And one of the things that you can prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan, you've got your brothers here from Melbourne. West Melbourne. Werribee Islamic Society and Mosque. They are brothers very dear to me. I've known them for a very long time. I've been working closely with them for a long time, with the imams, the head of the organization, a number of imams, Sheikh Isa and Sheikh Nawaz and other brothers who are part of this organization. They are establishing one of Australia's largest Islamic center, Werribee Islamic Community Center and Mosque. I visited their site. They've already started the work. They're already going underground and building a big mosque and an Islamic center, a number of things they are trying to do there in Melbourne. So they're today, inshallah, collecting funds. You could go give it directly to them. And at the same time, they've got a fundraiser tomorrow. Tomorrow at 7 p.m. at the Westella, at the Renaissance Litkem, known as the oldest teller. One ticket is $50. It's a good opportunity for you to prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan, invest for the hereafter, and at the same time, one of the things that you can set your actions, your mind and your heart straight. So I urge every single one of you to try and help and support your brothers here from Melbourne. He came from Melbourne, that arrived here today in the morning. They came past the Yumei and he though with us at the back. Whatever you can contribute towards this masjid, whatever you can give towards that masjid, whatever you can do as a form of contribution towards establishing one of the houses of Allah Azza wa Jalla, one of the credible organizations and big Islamic centers in Australia, inshallah, do so. So your brothers are there, just opposite to the entrance and the exit point. So try and help them as much as you can. Try and buy a ticket and attend tomorrow's dinner. If you can't attend tomorrow's dinner, at least buy a ticket and consider that to be one of the contributions that you want to contribute towards the organization, that masjid. And alhamdulillah, Islam is growing. I told you this 100 times. Wallahi, by Allah, I don't care about what's going to happen to Islam. I don't care. I'm not worried. Allah's taking care of it, not you, not me. I care about what role do I have in Islam. I'm not worried about what's going to happen to Islam. I'm not worried about the future of Islam. Allah's taking care of that. And the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of it, it's not like the way you and I are going to take care of it. At the end of the day, Islam is protected by Allah, not by you, not by me. My concern is, where do I fit in when it comes to upholding the deen of Allah? Where do I fit in when it comes to serving Islam? About Islam, I'm not worried. Islam is going to grow. Islam is going to grow with you or without you. Islam is going to grow. Whether people attack it or not, Islam is going to grow. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, you see Allahu Akbar in the last 15, 20 years, you could see how Islam is growing everywhere. Everywhere you go, mashallah, mosque centers just opening. With all the attacks that Islam is facing, encountering, and the Muslim community is facing, encountering, subhanAllah, Islam just continues to grow. And you know what? And it will continue to grow. بِعِزِّ عَزِيز أَوْ بِذِلِّ ذَلِيل. As the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ says, with the honor of those who seek honor, or the disgrace and the dishonor of those who seek disgrace and honor. Islam is going to grow, my brothers in Islam. Don't worry about Allah's deen. I'm telling you, I'm not. Don't think, well, oh, I'm worried about Islam. And Allah's taking care of Islam. You're not taking care of it. Allah's taking care of it. Worry about what do you do towards the revival of Islam? What do you do towards contributing to these Islamic organizations and masjid? Worry about what you're doing when it comes to supporting the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Islam is going to grow. Let the entire world face it. Let the entire world challenge it. Let the entire world continue targeting and fighting against Islam. Islam will just continue to thrive. Islam will just going to continue to grow because it's been taken care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So at the end, the challenge is not between them and Muslims. The challenge is between them and Allah. The challenge is with Allah, not with Muslims. We are only Ameen. The challenge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Una. Whoever wants to challenge Allah, we all know who's going to be the loser and who's going to be the winner at the end of the day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us for this deen, and may Allah azza wa jalla continue safeguarding us.